and this is the important thing to note here, and particularly the lumbar portion, the loin. So this confirms Hansweir's description of Sylv as the loins, and this actually says that this word specifically refers to that region as well. It goes on to talk about how this word is used, and Dr. Lane then quotes an authority who mentions a phrase of the Arabs. So this is authority whose initials are given there, who mentions a phrase of the Arabs, but essentially says that these are the sons of their loins. So this is and we see the root there, the sad, the lam, and the ba, and this is actually them plural. So we see that these are the sons of their loins, and then it goes on to explain this. So this is the phrase in which this word is used, and we see it refers specifically to the loins. And it goes on to say, because of the sperma of the man is held to proceed from the sulb of the man. The sulb of the man. So actually this, another evidence. So we had earlier on that this is said about a man. Now this is the sulb of the man, so referring specifically to the man. And very interestingly actually, as is said in the, and then a reference is given here. Now this is actually very amazing. So this is Roman numerals. L stands for 50, X stands for 10, we have three of those, that's 80, V is 5, so that's 85, and the I is 1, so that's 86. So it's referring to Surah 86 verse 7. So the sulb of the man, as is said in Surah 86. So we can see clearly this is talking about the sulb of the man. So now we're on page 301 of Lane's lexicon, and we're looking at this word here, Tara'ib, and this gives meanings as part of the breast, which is in the place of the collar or the necklace, the bones of the breast, so breast bones is the common translations that we see. And it goes on to talk about the four ribs on the right side and the four ribs on the left thereof. So it actually talks about the formation, actually, the ribs that arch up almost to form the link with the breastbone. So Dr. Lane quotes authority here, whose initials are here, MF, says that Tara'ib relates to males and females in common. So this is actually saying that it relates to males and females in common. This is one authority quoted. Dr. Lane then goes on to say, and this is very, very important, but most of the authors on strange words affirm decidedly that it is peculiar to women. So there's two things that we learn from here. A, that this is a strange word, a rare Arabic word. And most of the authors, aside from the one quoted above, most of the authors on strange words, according to Dr. Lane, affirm that decidedly. So not just an affirmation, but a decided affirmation. This is actually very specifically that this is particular or peculiar to women. Now, the thing I would like you to bear in mind is that the term breastbone is obviously not particular to women. So the sense in which this is particular to women is something that I'm quite interested in. But what we confirm here, this is a strange Arabic expression and it's particular to women. So what I've demonstrated here is that a sulb is referring to loins, as in the phrase, these are the sons of their loins, as was given in Lane's lexicon, and is specific to the man. And at-tara'ib is a rare Arabic expression, a strange Arabic word, which most authorities say is particular to women and is descriptive of the breastbones or the ribs. So what I'm going to look at now is how Muhammad Asad explains the word at-tara'ib as the pelvic arch of the woman. So if one were to go to, so for example, islamcity.com and look at Quran search and then find Surah 86 and the Muhammad Asad translation, and if you look at the verse that we're dealing with specifically here, which is verse 7, and this is the Muhammad Asad translation, and it's translated as issuing from the loins of the man a sulb, which we've confirmed actually with Hansweir's dictionary and Dr. Lane's lexicon, and the pelvic arch of the woman. There's actually a translator's note written by Muhammad Asad, so let's have a read of what that actually says. It says, the plural noun, tara'ib, rendered by me as pelvic arch, has also the meaning of ribs, or arch of bones, according to most of the authorities who have specialized in the etymology of rare Quranic expressions. This term relates specifically to the female anatomy, and then he quotes Taj al-Urus. The Taj al-Urus, as far as I'm aware, is not available in the English translation. If it is, and someone could forward me a link to that, or where I could get that, then I'd love to get hold of it. But essentially, I can confirm most of the information within this comment by the sources that I have. So we know that the meaning is ribs from Panzerwehr and from the Dr. Lane's lexicon. The term breast bones or the ribs is descriptive of an arch of bones. And according to the Dr. Lane's lexicon, we know that this is a rare chronic expression and relates specifically to females. So I have no issues with accepting actually that this is the pelvic arch. Unless someone can demonstrate to me actually that this is incorrect, I have no reason to doubt that it is correct. So in response to Dr. Qureshi, what I would say is that I've demonstrated by using known and established meanings of the word as-sulub al-tara'ib, that these verses are talking about a fluid that gushes forth between as-sulub, the loins of the man, and this would be referring to the semen, and the al-tara'ib, the pelvic arch of the woman, which would be referring to the ovum, which is surrounded by the follicular fluid. So actually your case for scientific inaccuracy actually is deficient. Now, have I then turned a potentially miraculous statement into an obvious statement? Then I think you'd have to look at when the ovum and the follicular fluid were discovered. And I think you'd find that actually this was quite recent as opposed to when Muhammad, peace be upon him, was around. What I'd like to do now actually is that apply Dr. Qureshi's understanding of the verse as being specifically referring to the man only, and apply his preferred translations of Shakir and Yusuf Ali, and demonstrate actually even these with this understanding are not incorrect. Okay, so here we have a sagittal view of the male pelvis, the lower half of it anyway, and if we apply Dr. Qureshi's understanding of the verse, we have here we have the coccyx, which is the lower end of the spine, the athulb, and the ribs, the at-tara'ib, would be somewhere above this region. So anywhere between athulb and at-tara'ib would be where the emission the Quran is talking about it would be coming from. Now most people from what I've read on some of the comments left on Dr. Qureshi's video blog think that the ejaculate comes from the testes. This of course is incorrect. The testes simply produce the sperm, which only form about 1 or 2% of the final volume of the semen that's ejaculated anyway, so this is not correct. The sperm then is moved up around the bladder, actually the rest via the vas deferens, and the rest of the vas deferens actually isn't drawn on here, is moved up around the bladder into the seminal vesicles. The remaining volume, the 95 to 98% of the semen volume, is produced from the seminal vesicles and actually the prostate as well. And we have the Cowper gland, which isn't actually labeled in this diagram, which also releases some mucus into the urethra there as well. So what happens is that the semen is released along the ejaculatory duct and out through the urethra. And this, where is this release from? Baina, between a thulb, the coccyx, and at-tara'ib, the ribs, according to the translations that Dr. Qureshi uses. So what I've demonstrated actually is that even using Dr. Qureshi's preferred translations, and if you apply those translations to the anatomy in a fair manner, then you realize actually these verses are still scientifically accurate. However, any look at the verses in much more detail, ignoring the false premise of the textual acrobatics that Dr. Qureshi put forward in his presentation, you get revealed much more specific information of a scientific nature. Assalamu alaikum, YouTube. Bismillah.